I'd like to show you my latest project, this computerized chessboard. But first, a bit of history. Back in 1978, when I was a 12-year-old boy, I was really into chess and electronics. And my parents, for Christmas, gave me this wooden chess set, which I used to play my friends and also do puzzles from the newspaper. And the very next year, my parents gifted me a chess computer. It was called the Chess Challenger 7 from Fidelity Electronics. And I'm not sure how much they paid, but I found a 1979 Sears catalog that lists it for $94 US, which would have been over $100 Canadian. So the equivalent in today's dollars would have been about $500. So not a cheap gift. So I was very thankful to my parents. I played that chess computer endlessly. But unfortunately, I never actually got particularly good at playing chess. And 2 years later, I got my first real computer. And so I kind of forgot about the chess computer. But I continued my love of electronics, computers. And 44 years later, I decided to recreate that standalone chess computer in a slightly different form factor. So instead of a keypad and display, this board detects the locations of the pieces and lights up squares to indicate the computer's move. So one problem I had was how to detect the position of the pieces. What I decided to do was to take these old chess pieces, open up the bottom, and remove the metal weight in the base of each piece and replace it with a rare earth magnet. Then the board can use sensors, magnetic sensors, to detect the presence of a piece. So when I place a piece on the board, it lights up to indicate that it has detected the piece. Now let me move all the pieces over to the board and let's try playing a game. Now when I place the last piece, the colors change. Up until this point, the board did not really know what piece was on top of each square. But as soon as it sees this initial position, it assumes that you've placed appropriate pieces on the board to form the correct chess initial position. So let's start playing. I'm going to move this pawn. You see when I remove the piece, its light turns off. And when I place it, a new light turns on for that square. And immediately, the computer responds with its counter move, and it flashes to indicate the origin and destination squares. And let's continue. Good. In fact, I think this is my last move. Yep, that's checkmate. And as soon as I move this piece and the board will detect checkmate, it'll play an animation just to let you know the game is over. So that was a pretty good game, but I was expecting to lose and I did. All right, let's take a look inside the electronics to this device. Okay, I'll remove the screws that attach the top of the board. This board is actually a piece of dark gray acrylic, and the pattern on the board was created using a laser cutter and etcher that was available from the public library in Ottawa, where I live. It took about 20 minutes to etch the checkerboard pattern and the numbers on the top, and another, say, minute to cut the rounded rectangle out of the piece of stock. And I think it did a very good job. So let's remove this to take a look at what's inside. This is a circuit board that is actually a design that appeared in an electronics magazine called Nuts and Bolts. So I just repurposed this circuit. I had to order the circuit board from a manufacturer who custom made the board. Now there's a few other things here I want to point out. It's maybe hard to see, but there's standing off the board are 64 of these Hall effect sensors. So these are the magnetic sensors that detect whether a piece is present. And they're standing about a centimeter off the board. So they're just underneath the piece of acrylic, so they can pick up the magnets that are in the pieces. And there are a total of 16 lengths of RGB LED strips, about 5 meters of LED strips that have been cut and soldered to the board. This here is a microcontroller. It's called the Teensy LC for low cost, and it's responsible for scanning the Hall effect sensors and driving the LEDs. You need a microcontroller to do that because it's real-time critical. But the actual chess engine is running in this Raspberry Pi 02W, which has just enough resources to run the chess engine. And this is an addition that wasn't present in the Nuts and Bolts magazine article. So I've added this board and connected a few wires to the board. The original project from the magazine didn't actually play chess. It just showed you legal moves that using the lights, but didn't actually play a game of chess. So the addition of the Raspberry Pi allows it to play chess. And so that's the hardware. It was a fun project to create. I'll leave links to all the files for the software and for the laser cutter in the description. So please check that out if you're interested in building this. And thank you for watching my video.